No.
English?
I do recommend you learn a little bit of Spanish before coming, just the basics.
안녕하세요.
Hello everyone, we are here in Valencia, Spain, a coastal city that is the third largest in Spain of almost a million people. In this video, we're gonna show you the old town of Valencia, the modern areas of Valencia, and also what it's famous for, and that is paella. Paella is actually originated from the Valencia region, in a region just south of the Valencian city. We're gonna be taking you a tour to discover all the icons of Valencia so that you know what to do when you come here next time. Before we get started on the video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. It really helps us out and this channel grow. Let's check out this beach real quick.
The beaches in Valencia are flat and wide with soft sand between your toes. There are a lot of water sports you can do, or you can just lay down and enjoy a book and soak up the sun. There are a lot of stores, restaurants, cafes, and bars at the promenade that stretches a long ways. If you like the beach, then plan a day there on your trip to Valencia.
One of the must-visit places is the central market here in the old city of Valencia.
It's the largest market in the city and has a huge variety of things that you can eat and drink. There were meats, ham, cheese, fruits and vegetables, seafood, pastries, coffees, drinks, and a variety of snacks. You can definitely spend a few hours here if you're a foodie. We were pleasantly surprised that the prices were not inflated compared to other local markets. We got a snack of fuet and a cup of wine for 5 euros, which was all locally made and very delicious. The market officially closes at 3 p.m., but there are a lot of stores that will start closing at 2 p.m. So make sure you don't come here too late like we did.
If you're already visiting the central market here in the old city of Valencia, then you might want to check out the place right next to it, which is a 15th century Gothic mercantile exchange called La Lonja de la Seda.
It's a grandiose building that shows the riches of Valencia during its medieval golden age. It has elaborate stonework and huge vaulted ceilings. It's worth checking out if you have the time.
I really want to know where those stairs go. We are here at Virgin Square. That is what it's called in English because I can't pronounce the Spanish. But it's home of the Turia Fountain and lined with tons of historic buildings. So very close, you can go to the cathedral, a lot of historic sites very close by here. And it's lined with tons of outdoor cafes so you can have a nice refreshing drinks, food, and just have a nice time out here. Oh, we just got horchata, but horchata is originally made with rice. I'm not sure if this one is because I can't read Spanish. It's made with rice.
Wow.
Things that make something different.
저 사람들 표정이 그냥 그래서.
Yeah, it's not the same as the horchata that I know.
Wow.
But it's refreshing. Like I feel really good. We are gonna check out the Valencia Cathedral, one of the iconic places to check out while you're here. It is said that the Holy Grail resides in this.
Built on an ancient Roman temple that was later a mosque, the Cathedral of Valencia is a Gothic-style building, but it preserves many elements from different periods, from Romanesque to Baroque eras. In the 15th century, the chapter house was built where the Holy Chalice is now housed. Archaeological studies suggest that the Holy Chalice is the one used by Jesus in the Last Supper. If you are a believer or not, the cathedral is still worth a visit.
Another day here in Valencia, and today we started a little late. I can kind of fight off the hangry for a long time, but it's kind of awkwardly quiet. So the first meal of the day we're having at this local place that our Airbnb host recommended. Bread in America comes with like butter, but here they give us a slice of salami. I think it's salami, to be honest. I don't know what it is, but it's meat. One of the things we were experiencing here. Yeah, yeah, move over. So when you're eating, drinking out in the streets, it's a beautiful, gorgeous day, but there's a lot of flies when you're eating. Maybe it's just us. We're fresh meat. We're fresh meat to the flies. Oh, there it is. So we've learned our lesson. I think from now on during lunch, we're gonna eat probably inside. But it seems like during the day, that's when the flies are active. Because when we eat at night, there's no flies. But Ted did not enjoy that experience because of the flies. Now we are on the east part of Valencia in this park that basically surrounds half the city from the north all the way to the east. And they have some really cool new modern architectures. We are really bummed about this. This was one of the places we really wanted to check out today. It's Gulliver's Park. It's basically, there's Gulliver and you're basically all the little people that tie him down and run around on top of him going down slides, stairs, towers, but it's under renovation. So the next itinerary is going to be Palo de las Artes, or the Art Center, and it's the bigger than I thought. Look at this. This part of Valencia is the newer part of the city. We're right now at the Science Center. There's the performance art over there that you saw earlier, and then the aquarium that's a bit further down. If you notice, I'm by myself. There's a lesson here that we've learned that you need to know when you come here, especially in the summer, is the sun is hot here in Spain. So all of us are pretty exhausted from being in the sun. And I'm here to get these shots just for you. Hey Chloe.
Hi.
How are you feeling?
햇빛 너무 뜨겁고 지금 눈도 크게 못 뜨고 해서 왜 사람들이 브라탄만 입고 다니는 줄 알겠다.
We are taking a break from the sun. All of us are literally overheating. So what do? Nice, cold pint of beer.
Yeah.
Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
Come here.
Wow, 정말 시원하다. 아, 코코스 진하네.
So this is called guacamole calavera. And we tried to find out what it is on the internet, and we looked up calavera. And it's a skull. So why is this called guacamole skull? I asked the waiter when he came, and it's like, well, why is it called that? He was like, it's just a name. So I'm actually worried it's really spicy. I'm gonna shed green for a while.
Oh shoot, it's spicy.
No, I'm just kidding, it's not spicy. Oh, whoa, it's good, honey, here. Dad, you're gonna love this. All right, ready to do a switch? Ready? One, two, three.
Delicious.
Now that we had a break and cooled off with a nice glass of beer and some snacks, we are out here to take some really good shots. Here, check it out. I hope you liked it. This place is awesome. I highly recommend you come out here to check it out. We're gonna be back here in the morning during sunrise to show you how awesome this place looks. So wait for those footages right here. It is 6 o'clock in the morning. I'm barely awake. Chloe's gonna be sleeping in while Ted and I are gonna be capturing the sunrise. Ted, you up? I'll take that as a yes. You ready to go? And we're back here to capture the sunrise, and there's still a party happening, and it's almost 7 o'clock in the morning. I'm really impressed. You guys know how to party here in Valencia. So this is the Science Center that we saw early in the video. And yes, it is no one around technically, but my expectation versus reality is this. So we just learned that officially the party ends at 7 a.m. But if you want to come here in the morning, it is beautiful. And if you don't want to wake up, then stay up all night partying, then come out here for the sunrise. Hot tip for you. Have to go into these buildings and like scope them out. Just being out here, you can spend a whole day just hanging around out here. And the flies again. Yeah. But Valencia, definitely a cool place to visit if you ever get a chance, except for the flies. Oh geez, what the heck, it's coming after me. So when you think of Spain, what food comes to mind? And if you're thinking paella, yes, you're correct. Valencia is the home of paella, but more accurately, it's actually the region south of Valencia in the Valencia district called Albufera. And right here, this is thought to believe the origin of paella that is now famous around the world.
So we are here today in Al Palmar in Albufera to enjoy this iconic dish.
Oh, this paella looks amazing.
Wow, 진짜 여기서 뭐 오리지널에서 먹어야 되네. 너무 맛있어. 이거 한국 사람들 너무 좋아할 것 같은데. 내가 한국 맛이 그리웠는데 이거 먹으니까 좀 생각이 없어졌어.
맛있는데. 근데 우리나라 볶음밥 최고.
아 진짜? 이거 너무 맛있는데.
Oh, it does remind me of a 한국 볶음밥. Like after you finish eating. Eating and then you put the rice in and put all the sauce.
Yeah,
yeah. 마지막에 yeah. 보통.
자기 이거 아마 이게 팔마 맞죠? 팔마.
무롱지.
무롱지. 어 무롱지 먹어봐. 진짜 맛있다.
근데 나 원래부터 누룽지 별로 안 좋아해.
아 그래?
근데 이빨에 끼는 게
근데 자기
사이.
한국인이야.
그럼 누룽지 나 줘.
아니 이빨에 사이에 끼는 게 싫더라. 나는. 근데 이 누룽지 괜찮네.
오 예. Yeah.
이 누룽지 촉촉하다.
This. This is what you want right here. The nurungji, the burnt rice.
It's not hard, but very flavorful. 그러면 나 첫 먹는 거 나쁘지 않은데 왜? 근데 밑에 누룽지 같이 먹으면 나 너무 좋아졌어.
I got you.
Thank you.
Oh, that sound.
We got sunset tickets for a boat ride, and here's the shot. This was so unexpected to be on this boat ride during sunset. I mean, we literally came here for paella, and we just so happened to learn that this is kind of the origin of paella. But being out here in the country where the rice paddies are, this lagoon that used to be part of the ocean right here, it's been a special day. Thanks for joining us in this video in discovering and exploring the major icons of Valencia. It's actually one of our favorite cities that we've ever visited so far on our trip around the world. And we highly recommend that if you ever decide to come to Spain, please check out Valencia. I also want to give a shout out to Ted right there. He provided a lot of footages that you see in this video, such as the transitions with Chloe and I walking together. But speaking of Chloe, you probably noticed that she's not around. Where is she? Well, at the end of our Valencia trip, we went to La Tomatina, which is the festival where you basically have a giant food fight with 150 tons of tomatoes, 30,000 people, and just, it's madness. Check out the video, which is coming up next. If you want to find out what happened to Chloe, here it is. So, Chloe got COVID from La Tomatina. She tested positive a couple of days ago. I've tested negative. I have no symptoms, but I am being cautious when I go out, so that's why I was in the park. Try to avoid, you know, crowds and people.
너무 아파.
필요한 거 막 해줘, okay?
됐어.
So really quick, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon. Please, it really helps this channel. See you next time. Bye. She's out of it. We're going to the Virgin Square next. Only virgins can go. See, that's why it's right by the church.